of the day, we had several discussions as to which group we could have, and somebody did mention a new group called Queen. And they may or may not have been booked, but something happened at the last minute and they didn't make it.
We very nearly didn't do it. We was rehearsing for the Anarchy tour at the time, and this big limousine turned up outside this place in Holsden. We, you know, punk rockers and all that. I thought, well, we're not getting in that thing. We don't want to do that. We want to stay here and have a drink and hang out with the lads and rehearse and do that. Don't want to do it. And this sort of phone call came through from Malcolm McLaren saying, well, if you don't do it, your wages will be stopped that week. So he was in this car like a shot.
They were only allotted 90 seconds, and I thought, well, not much can go wrong. I was wrong.
They are punk rockers. The new craze, they tell me. They are heroes, not the nice, clean Rolling Stones. You see, they are as drunk as I am. They are clean by comparison. They are a group called the Sex Pistols. And I'm surrounded now by all of them. Just let us see the Sex Pistols in action. Come on, chicks.
Grundy had very little patience for anything that wasn't classical music.
I am told that that group have received £40,000 from a record company. Doesn't that seem to be slightly opposed to their anti-materialistic view of life?
No, or... more the merrier.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
Well, tell me more about it.
We've been spending it, haven't we?
I don't know, have you?
Yeah. Yeah. It's all gone.
Really?
Down the boozer.
40, really? Good Lord.
Steve said something out of earshot, more or less. Said the dreaded F word, but I didn't even notice it, and I was talking at the time.
I could talk to Bill through his earpiece and tell him to cut the interview right there and then, and we could actually get into a film very quickly. But again, as you know, that takes about 30 seconds to get a film rolling, so you've still got 30 seconds of abuse to listen to. And then you've got to rely on your guys on the studio floor to get the person out of the studio, which could lead to even more trouble than the interview was to start with. So as this was the last story in the programme, we'll let it go.
Beethoven, Mozart, Bach, yes, and Brahms have all died.
Bears, aren't they? Yes.
Really? Oh, what are we saying,
wonderful
sir?
Wonderful people.
Are they?
Oh, yes, they really turn us on.
What do they do?
Well, suppose they turn other people on.
That's just their touch, isn't it?
It's what?
Nothing, a rude word. Next question.
No. What was the rude word?
Shit.
It became a face-off kind of situation. It was who had the most bottle.
Are you worried, or are you just enjoying yourself?
Enjoying myself.
Are you?
Yeah.
That's what I thought you were doing.
I always wanted to meet you.
Did you really? Yeah. We'll meet afterwards, shall we?
You dirty son. You dirty old man.
Well, keep going, Chief. Keep going. Go on, you've got another 5 seconds. Say something outrageous.
You dirty bastard.
Go on, again.
You dirty
What a clever boy.
What a f***ing rotter.
Well, that's it for tonight.
I don't think I've ever wanted to hear our signature tune, Windy, so much. I mean, I just couldn't wait to hear Windy.
The other rocker, Abel, and I'm saying nothing else about him, will be back tomorrow. I'll be seeing you soon. I hope I'm not seeing you again. From me, though, good night.